Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to King's Bounty, the Let's Play. So my goal here is actually, before we go hunting, I think we can boat over these, yes. Before we go hunting this woman down, hey, extra weekly income, sure. What I want to do is see if we can maybe find some town portal scroll or town portal time stop scrolls on this continent without having to, you know, go all over the place, because they are super handy. At this point, like, anything on this continent, I think we're going to be able to just kind of steamroll due to party size, do not care about gnomes. But I just kind of want it, just in case, you never know. Could be handy to have, you know? I shouldn't have moved my pikemen that far forward. The wolves are going to be able to chew on them. It's not going to matter, but poor strategy. We lost the guy that we didn't have to lose. Oh well. But yeah, what do we got here? Skeletons, don't care. I would consider maybe cavorting with, if we got like maybe some demons or, oh fuck, I didn't mean to go into this fight. I wasn't paying attention. I'm like, oh, this is easy, it's just ghosts. This time though, we are ready. Fuck those guys. And I'm going to have my range to just whittle those dwarves down, so by the time they're actually up to the melee, their numbers should be sufficiently dwindled, I would hope. Yeah, they'll probably be down to like 4. Silly skeletons. They tried. And for their hubris, they were slain. Seriously, guys, you only killed one? Dumpster tier roll there, archers. Dumpster tier roll. It's okay, our pikemen are gonna fuck these guys up. Oh, alright. Archers, all is forgiven. 2900 gold. That was pretty solid. And hey, we have done a full circle. That's a nasty random encounter there. The enemy groups are, like, random in this, based on, you know, where they are on the map and stuff. These peasants are always here, I believe, but that's, Jesus Christ, we could have 600 peasants, you guys. I don't know how useful it would be, but we could do it. If I really wanted to. Which I don't. But if I really wanted to, we could do it. Oh, God damn it. There's just a slight delay with the, like, button press and the action, and it's fucking me up. I'm losing turns. My elves could have gone and killed all of these skeletons, saving 2 of my militia, but they didn't. The lazy bastards. Never trust an elf. Alright, so that's just full of monsters, I believe. I do not want peasants. Still do not want peasants. Let's see here. Gather information. Castle Nurse Legs under no one's rule. Let me have a look at my map. As you can see, like, these are not small continents. So I don't expect this Let's Play is going to be over long. I'm going to be mostly goal-oriented here. But for the time being, I'm just trying to enjoy going back to, this is probably one of, like, growing up, this is probably one of my favorite games. Like, I played the shit out of this. I don't even remember where I got it originally. Maybe in, like, some Heroes of Might and Magic pack or something. But man, like, it stuck with me. Okay, hey, extra weekly income. Vicious group of monsters. Find villain, yoink! Where is she? Castle Kankamar, which, according to the manual, is at 3649 on the map. Okay, so she's in, like, the upper right-ish chunk of the map. Okay, now we know. Vampires. I can't remember if vampires, I don't think vampires are like ghosts in that when they kill, they add more to their numbers. But they do heal themselves, I believe. And they can fly. We might be able to kill these guys. They're beefy. They've got 30 hit points apiece. I'm going to leave my pikemen there, because if these things come back here... Okay, so we only got one. So this isn't going to be too bad. They only deal 3-6 damage. They're just beefy flyers. Really good harassers. Probably going to go for... probably going to go for my militia, if I had to guess. Alright, so those vampires are probably at full health. Come down here. Let the pikemen do their jobs. The upside, and my hope, is that having killed those things, this fight will actually be worth some good money. So this thing is going to kill itself on our pikes. Yep, 3,400 gold, not bad. That was definitely worth what we put into it. That's what the later parts of this game come down to in a lot of ways, is like, is this encounter going to be worth the units I'm going to expend on it? And I think it's kind of interesting. It's at this point in time, we're basically just kind of rolling across the countryside, killing anything that dares get in our way. But that will not always be the case. Later on, we'll be fighting stuff like demons and dragons and all kinds of very nasty stuff. Demons in particular can be very, very dangerous. Like, their special ability is that if they attack somebody, they have a chance. It's not guaranteed, but they have a chance that they just have the stack. So, like, if you've got 1,000 units, one demon can kill 500 of them, just if they get lucky, and it's horrible. It's just really bad, but... thankfully, demons are very, very rare to encounter, so I'm not really overly worried. Of course, you know, pride before the fall and all that good jazz. These wolves are gonna kill themselves on my pikes. Yep, they tried. A for effort. And these peasants are just... no. Hey, a castle gate spell. That's actually pretty handy. Alright. Doesn't really look like a whole heck of a lot back here. Just some loot. The reason that we're exploring and I'm still getting these treasure chests is because there are chances to get goodies in them. Like, you guys saw that, like, there's everywhere that a chest spawns, I believe there's also a chance for one of the artifacts to spawn, and we want basically all of them. They're all pretty good. And then scoot around the coast here. I'd be careful about holding that movement button down. Max spell capacity. Sure, we'll kill these guys. And the reason, like, right now we're heavy on ranged. That's probably going to be how it is most of the game. I like playing a more ranged heavy composition because in doing so, we spend less money in fights, especially like garbage fights like this, where these things could theoretically kill some of my dudes, but with archers, they're going to be dead before they get to me to do so. And that's, you know, kind of nice. Especially, like, in this case, where we're fighting enemies that are just so slow. Like, these things are just, with one move speed, they have just no chance of getting down to us. I am thinking very strongly of replacing those militia with something. Probably wolves, honestly, based on what we've encountered. Oh, hey, time stop. I'm just gonna take all of those. Extra magic capacity. Hey, I would like another. I can learn zero more. So how are my spells? We got 5 time stops. We have a castle gate. We actually do have a lightning spell. Teleport can be useful. It lets you like move one of your units wherever you want in the combat. So it can be good for like getting an archer out of melee, getting a melee into melee, etc., etc. So here, let's cast a spell. Let's lightning. So that is what D. Let's lightning the peasants. We killed 20 of them. It's not always great. You generally speaking, like, if you're gonna cast spells, there are other spells that are probably better to cast, but it was a freebie. Why not? Let my militia actually see some action here. Killing a couple peasants. That's all militia are good for. Is this her? No, this is Baron Jano. We'll be back for him. Oh, hey, wolves. Ooh, do I want 150 wolves? I do. I like wolves. Weekly income. Can I actually see? We are making 5,200. How much is my army going to cost? I don't know if it will let me look. Controls. Wait until the end of the week. Search. Okay, here we go. Gold cost. Yeah, our army is still. It's nearing not, but it's affordable enough. And I know here, let me dismiss my militia. Let me have a look-see. So you can see that our elves are on low morale. That means that they're going to hit for less and so on. But oh well, that's okay. Okay. Arrow down the wolves. Get you up there. Just kill some peasants. That makes everybody feel better. What I would like to see are maybe some druids. Druids are the most powerful of the forest units, which is where elves are from. And they're basically elves, but they throw lightning bolts. It's pretty wonderful. Okay. Is she over here? Is there a castle? There's gotta be like a castle around here somewhere. But they're throwing all these junk encounters at me. Oh, you fools. You're all dead. I mean, I suppose if nothing else, it's like easy little, you know, kind of drips of gold here and there. Another castle gate. Finding spells like that will let us go past our limit of spells known. Zombies, wolf skulls. No, screw you guys. I'm not even in the mood. And are we back? Yeah, we're back in the fucking desert. Ugh. Petulant rage. Just absolute petulance. Man, these wolves. Whatever those wolves get a hold of, they are going to fucking ruin it. And it's gonna be wonderful. A lot of ghosts. Nope. I'm in trouble. Can I grab a boat? Oh, we're gonna have to fight a lot of ghosts. 78. Ooh, do I have any magic that I can do anything with? We might be in trouble here. I don't know what a resurrect. No armies need resurrecting. Oh, no. These ghosts are going to, like, absolutely ruin us. If they didn't have three movement, I could dick around with them, but they do. Here, because, like, I can, for now, I can just, like, teleport them down here. But, yeah, if we're killing them one or two at a time, we're in trouble, I think. Because, yeah, those things, whatever those things retaliate across, they are just going to fucking ruin it. Yeah, that's pretty bad. Let's see what my wolves can do to them. 9. Oh, that is... Oh, this is so bad. Oh, we are fucked. We are just absolutely fucked. Kill these damn orcs. Jesus. So yeah, this is just going to have to be a unit on the map that we avoid, because there is no way we're going to be able to kill these things unless I, like, come in here with, like demons and get really lucky on having the stack or something. Because, yeah, like, exponential power growth type thing. Alright, so we're gonna just give that up. Yep, disgrace, etc, etc. So we have 17,000 gold pieces. Let's grab some archers. Let's grab 300 apiece. A couple pikemen. This should suffice for now. We're just going to have to go on foot, I think, sadly. Let's see if we can't maybe rabble rouse a little bit here. As I say, I think I'm going into a dead end, aren't I? No, we're actually. We might actually have to wait, get some money. Let's see here. 3,000 just to get another boat. There we go. then new, and we'll go to Archipelia. So now, we're here looking for money. Oh, the Book of Necros. Sure, I think that just doubled our spell power, if I had to guess. Or maybe the max number of spells. Probably more likely the max number of spells. Let's see here. The Book of Necros. Tomat of Legend. The Book of Necros is rumored to increase the spell memory of any spellcaster. Shrouded in mystery, the whereabouts of the book are unknown, although rumor of a minor wizard's rapid rise to power have had fingers pointing. Alright, I'll take it. I ain't gonna complain. Resurrect spells, which, while nice, are not what I want. Hey! Complete map, but if I recall correctly, it's not permanent, sadly. Archmages? That's a big ol' nope. And there we go. We'll just come around. Anything? Just a town. Alas. We can sit and wait. Like, if we need to raise funds, I can just, like, dismiss my entire army and then just wait. Weekly income by 117. Here we go. 2,900 gold. That feels better. I'm only gonna grab a couple of these chests because, like, these are good amounts of leadership and I don't necessarily want to waste it. Cast spell. Time stop. Is there anything? Yes, there is. Town gates. I have to be careful. Gold. Gold. Spell capacity. And I have to cast another time stop. There we go. We can stack them if we want, but I generally don't like doing so because it feels kind of wasteful to me. Because, like, if you transition from, like, one area to another, I think it's all wasted. Like, you don't get the time back. 2,600 gold. Druids. Yes! Oh, we can get 24 of them. At 700 apiece, though. I'm gonna get 20. I like druids a lot. They're really powerful, you guys. You don't even know. Oh, man. Look at that. 40 to 60 damage. They're not as good as our archers, but look at how beefy they are. Oh, feels good. All right, let me wait for a week. See how we're looking here. Army's 31. Yeah, we're still okay. Just making sure that, like, my payments are still all right, because I do have to be careful not to, you know, get us in the lurch here. It's kind of slowly going through. Nope. Some ghosts can get fucked. Here, I'm actually going to time stop and flee so I don't have this thing follow me back, because this was a split area. Take that. Trolls. Trolls regenerate. Trolls are trolls. They're big ol' sacks of hit points. Not really too particularly interesting, if I am being honest. I would rather something like giants, where they have ranged attacks. Giants are pretty good in this. They have ranged attacks, and they're also beefy as hell. Oh, hey, ghosts. No. They are, like, the biggest trap unit. Hey! Saharia, which is the desert world. We can go over here. I think this is the last. I can't remember how many continents there are. Is it four or are there five? No, there's only four. This is where endgame happens and the whole place is a fucking desert. So we'll just do the outskirts, and if I recall correctly, the NPC monsters here, like, their icon is like a little archer guy. Yeah, look at that. So let's see what kind of enemies we got here. Druids, vampires, dragons. No. By the time we get here, I can't say that we'll be moving almost exclusively under the effects of time stop, but we will be using a lot of time stop. Time stop is a really good spell. You guys got anything? Oh, hey, it's time stop. Okay. I will never say no to stocking up on time stop. It doesn't really surprise me that there's no goodies out on the outskirts. If we were to go into the desert, we could, but the way it works is that every square you step on in the desert will expend a use of your time stop spell if you do not have flight. So no. Alright, Week of the Vampires, yeah, it's not looking like any goodies, sadly. Oh well, and that is Saharia. Back to Continentia. So let's go and see if we can't find this chick and murder her. How's our army look? We need pikemen. I need more than 6 pikemen. 12,000 gold pieces. 10's 3, so we'll grab 40. Alright. Where'd my boat go? Where'd I leave it? There it is. Okay, pikemen are basically just in our party for hit points. Although, to be honest, the rest of our group has some durability to them. More gold per week. What is this? Canagor the Mystic. Good to know. Another resurrection spell. Resurrection is something that I should be casting in fights, if I'm being honest with you all. Is she here? No. We also need a freaking... We need siege weapons. I'm just frittering away all of our time. I mean, I'm not worried. Oh, that's the... That right there is fuckery. Okay, there's our siege weapons. Okay. That's that pack of ghosts. Thankfully, it's somewhere where I don't think it can really do much in the way of harm. So how in the heck? Because my thinking is that her castle's right here, I think. Maybe. We'll see. I can't say that we're going to be capturing one of these people every episode, but I would like to keep that pace, because there are a fair number of them. And we also, like, we won't need all of them to win the game. More weekly income, spell capacity. Sure. An easy fight. I can show off the druids. Kill these guys. Or not. Be terrible. Lightning bolt. 4 damage. So the way the druids work, I believe, is that, like, they have their damage that it shows, that they're doing, you know, however much, 2 to 3 apiece. But I think their actual damage is higher than that because they're doing lightning bolt damage, not their damage. But I may be wrong on that. Who knows? Gnomes. Vampires, peasants, sprites. Yeah, okay. 4 vampires. Eh. This could be... kind of rough. If I had to guess, they're going to fly in right north of my archers. So I'm going to move my pikes here. I'm going to lightning bolt these fuckers. Yeah! I love druids! The only downside to druids is they can only fire, like, I think 4 times. And they just killed my peasants, which is really just a mercy as far as I'm concerned. Alright, 3,000 gold. And then another 100 on top of it. We're just rolling in it. See, I think we're gonna have to take our boat around. However, I'm probably gonna try to keep episodes of this fairly brief, like around the 20-minute mark. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and call this here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time, wherein the hunt continues. Until then.